Well, as our loved ones get older, the dynamic shifts and they often depend on us more. Today we are talking about home care options versus choosing a facility. And here to tell us more is Dr. Bill Blanc. He's a board certified primary care physician with Mebane Medical Clinic and a member of Cone Health Medical Group. This is such a hard discussion that many families struggle with.
Certainly, it's a difficult decision to make as people age, they become more frail, mm-hmm. and often there isn't someone at home to take care of them, and so they have to make a decision about whether they're going to go into a facility or whether they're going to try to provide for them in the home.
And then, so how do you know when it's time to go to the facility versus continuing care at home?
Well, you know, that's a decision that varies from individual to individual.
In case by
and
case,
I think
yeah.
certainly working with the your physician mm-hmm. And other health professionals can help you make that decision.
There are often times where people come across hesitation with going to other facilities, and there's obviously a concern because it's their loved one, but
sure.
they can learn more about the options available.
Right, and there are several options available for home care.
Mm-hmm.
Most insurances will pay for home health care if there's an acute event, mm-hmm. Like a hospitalization or an injury or a stroke or a heart attack. There's also the availability of adult daycare, mm-hmm. Which is where individuals can be go to daycare during the day and be picked up again at the end of the day so when the family members are working. There's also a PACE program, which is for people that would otherwise need to go to a nursing home that provides care during the day. And another option that people often don't consider is hospice, which is for people with terminal illnesses that have a life expectancy of 6 months or less.
We often hear about people having the conversation about wills and what to do with those assets once they pass. They have the conversation, you know, years ahead of time. Is this a conversation you should be having?
Very much so. Advance directives are extremely important. It's one of those conversations that you really need to have with people as they age, and you need to do it early when they can make clear decisions and can have these conversations because you don't know what somebody wants unless you ask them.
Yeah, and that way it'll be a more pleasant experience for everyone making the transition.
Exactly, because if there's an acute event, if someone ends up in the hospital and you haven't had these conversations, it makes it very difficult to make decisions for them.
Well, thank you so much for coming in with that information.
Okay, well, thank you.
We appreciate it so much. We should mention that Cone Health offers a variety of services as you or your loved one gets older, including specialized primary care and retirement living communities. You can learn more by logging on to conehealth.com/aging.
House Call on Fox 8 is sponsored by Cone Health.